2 of this 8-man. I'm going to be on the play of this game. This hand's not great, but I don't think it's a mulligan. I'm going to keep. I'm going to lead with plains and then go plains, forest, and then I can get 2 duels with those that come into play untapped. I'm not sure when I'm going to play this Den Protector. I'm probably going to wait. I mean, if I don't draw anything else, you know, I can play turn 3 face down Den Protector and hopefully he'll have something that I can fight and have my guy live. Okay, so Gideon. I'm trying to think if that really changed anything. I'm more tempted to play my Den Protector face up now, because I can play Den Protector face up, and then on turn 3, I can, like, you know, if somehow he doesn't have another threat, I can, like, Dromoka's Command and 2-for-1 myself to kill this Warden, but if it lets me play Gideon onto an empty board, I think it's worth it. That being said, it still feels pretty awful, and the chance that I do get to play Gideon on an empty board is not super likely. I'm just gonna pass. I just don't feel like I'll have time to really do anything with this Den Protector, though. I think I'm gonna play it. Like I said, just the ability to play Den Protector on an empty board is pretty important. Or even if I can't play it on an empty board, you know, even just playing it and be able to block something while I have Gideon in play, because I have a double Dromoka's Command, so untapping with Gideon is like pretty important, because like I can make Gideon a 5/5 and then kill 2 of his creatures. And not have to worry about killing my Gideon because it's indestructible. Okay, I do like this now. Because, yeah, so if he plays Anafenza on turn 3, then I'm just gonna. Didn't attack. Okay. This is insane for us. If he tries to level end of turn, I just get to kill his guy for free. Gnarled was actually a good draw, though. I still think I'm just gonna pass. I definitely wanna kill his guy. His play was very weird. I should probably attack too. I guess if I attack, he might just block and let him trade, but I guess that's fine with me too. Yeah. Oh, he can't block. Yeah, Den Protector, I forgot about this ability. So yeah, so if he tries to pump now, I'm just gonna kill it. Yeah, his play was very weird. I don't know if he just like forgot that my cards do stuff or what, but and now we just gotta play Gideon here. I think I'm gonna fetch. I don't really want to draw the Smoldering Marsh. I think we're basically locked to win this game. Gideon is such a swingy card. It's one of those cards where if I'm a little bit ahead and I have it, I feel like I can't possibly lose. But if I'm like kind of behind, it just feels unplayable. Let's do this. I could either fight his Siege Rhino or play Wingman Rock. I'm pretty sure I want to fight his Siege Rhino and then play Snapping Gnarled. Make my Den Protector bigger here. Turn on that, have that fight that. Play this guy, and I'm not going to play my land. I don't think there's anything you could really have here. another rhino would be like probably his best bet, and that doesn't really do much at all. He might even just be dead on board when he blocks there and takes 4, 7, 9. Yeah, and he's especially dead. I'm not even gonna cast it. I'm just gonna attack everything. Alright. So I think I'm gonna board similar to how I boarded last time, but so what, I'm on the draw this game. So yeah, so I think I want both Tassigers, Wingmate, Self-Inflicted Wounds, and Transgresses. And then cut two Gideons, all the Den Protectors, like a Snapping Darler and Taroka's Command, I guess. I really don't like cutting those last two, but there's really not much else to cut. Like, I could cut the last Gideon, but there are situations. I mean, if your draw is removal heavy, you can get to the point where you're playing Gideon on a mostly empty board, and it's still pretty good. Sand has potential to be great, but I don't think it's worth it. If I draw a green source, this hand is very good, but not good enough where I think it's worth the risk. So I'm going to mulligan. Sand's interesting. We'll see how it plays out. It's kind of the opposite of what I've been saying I think is good in the mirror. You know, I don't like being the reactive, you know, kill your guys and then try to play a big threat, you know, grind you out, but obviously, sometimes, you know, it's what you draw. It's possible that I should have put that Sunken Hollow on the bottom. I don't really need a second swamp, but with Tassigar, it's still just another land. Like, I think I'm just going to play this Windswept Teeth anyways to get a green-white land, even if I... Okay, well, that was good. Now I'm definitely playing this Windswept Teeth. I just have to stay ahead of his creatures and hope he doesn't have Gideon or Wingmate Rock. That was pretty good for me that he had that, so now he can't like play an Inoffensive here and then something next turn. So now I can basically always have the board clear on my turn. Or sorry, on his attack step, rather. So he can't... It's going to be hard for him to wingmate me this game. Unless, of course, he has Gideon. I think I want to wait. I don't think there's anything that's going to make me not Abzan Charm that, but it might change the way he plays, I guess. It probably won't. There's probably nothing it could change, but I also can't think of a way it could punish me. I guess if he just has literally not, like all lands, he might... No, even if he has all lands, he would animate this. I was gonna say he might just pump this. Then it's obviously better to hold up Abzan Charm. Probably can't beat a Gideon here, but hopefully he just doesn't have it. When I drew the forest, it's possible I should have gotten just plains with this. I think that was right, because I don't really care much about having double green, and then this would come into play untapped. So, like, say he just plays Gideon here, I could play Tassigar. I felt like I thought I was going to be, you know, just mostly using removal for the next few turns, but I definitely would like to play... Yeah, especially like right now, I'd rather play Tassigar here. That's very unfortunate. So that was definitely a mistake. Okay. I could have Abzan Charm this now that he activated that. He can't wingmate me though since he played that. If I Abzan Charm, I'll have three cards in my graveyard. And then if I draw a land that comes into play untapped, I can play that, play Tasker, and have Drabroka's Command up. So I think I do want to do that. I guess I could have just drawn two cards as well, but I'm not at the highest life total. That was okay, I guess. I'm guessing this is going to get Abzan Charm. He's got three cards in hand and just pass with four mana. So he could have like maybe Murder's Cut. I'd much prefer Murder's Cut since I have the Tasker. I guess he could even. So I'm not going to Abzan Charm it now. He could fight these two? That seems very poor for him. Yeah, just fetch. Surprised my Seizurano is still alive. Okay, self-inflictment. That makes sense. At least it goes to my graveyard and I can, you know, have a cheaper Tasker now. He's got three cards left. He's still got Abzan Charm mana up. So I have to be kind of careful playing into it. I think I want to tap out for Tasker. I want to delve my whole graveyard for Tasker. Then I can have Abzan Charm up if I want to cast it. And then just play my landed pass. See, if he Abzan Charms me, I might just fight his Warden, because then I can guaranteed kill something out of with my Drabroka's Command. Two, three. Although next turn, well, no, I have to kill his. No, I think I'm just gonna Abzan Charm his Warden, because the next turn I can like, if he leaves back a blocker or whatever, I can animate Shambling Vents, Drabroka's Command, fight something and then kill his Sorin. So yeah. Abzan Charm this guy. Hopefully he doesn't play like a Rhino or an Anafenza, or I guess a Gideon, that's pretty bad too. I can still kill a Sorin, but still not in the best shape though. Getting pretty close to just being dead, too. Come on. Ooh, that was actually. Well, I only have one card in my graveyard, never mind. I forgot I Tasker'd. It was still an okay draw. Alright, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and kill a Sorin. Not like that. Yeah, I would really rather fight his vampire, but I think I have to. Yeah, because otherwise he can just jump block, so. I guess if he has a Drabroka's Command, he can kind of blow me out here. But I can't beat that no matter what, so. Yeah. That's really bad. Yeah, I'm just dead. Okay, so on the play, I definitely want my Gideons back in. Don't think I'm going to have Tassigers in on the play. It's just... I don't know. I feel like just getting on the board quick and being very aggressive is good. So I like cards like Dromoka's Command and Snapping Gnarled. Not that I don't necessarily think Tasker was bad that game. It was fine, but it's kind of slow. And while 4/5 is nice, I think I would rather have cheap spells. I just want to cast more spells than my opponent. Still have to cut two more cards though. I feel like it might just be absurd to cut Gideon on the play, but I really do like my cheap spells here, so I'm going to do it. There's so many boards where I'm like, well, if he has Gideon here, I can't possibly win. So that probably means I should leave it in the deck. Murder's Cut has to be good. Again, it's just cheap. It really lets you cast two spells earlier than you normally would. I'm just going to trim Gideon. I just want to be aggressive, get him dead. Okay, this hand's okay. The mana's a little awkward. Shambling Vent here. So what, I could get a Canopy Vista with this, but I'd rather just save it. If I draw another basic, then it'll be an untapped land later. I don't know if I want to attack or not. I think I do. It's not likely he blocks, and if it trades, if we trade, it's fine. And because like that way, yeah. So if he blocks, now if he has an untapped mana, he doesn't get to use it this turn. Otherwise, he would get to use his two mana. So I think depriving him of that. I mean, obviously he might just like not have, kind of be in the same spot as me. But there's not that many two drops on the deck, and I have two mana fences here, so my hand is not very threat light. Yeah, so now if he just passes here, he just wasted his two mana. That was a good draw. I don't like his... Well, I mean, obviously we don't know what the rest of his hand is, but if he's going to be able to have two untapped mana, I don't think his block is very good. Silkgraf, okay. Gonna jam another Anafenza, I guess. Play this and get a Plains, I guess. So he got a White Source. He must have like a Gideon here. I mean, I can see if he just has Sunken Hollow in hand and maybe Wingmate Rock, that also makes sense. So it's Tassigar, it looks like. Or Murder's Cut. Murder's Cut. Okay, I was hoping it was Tassigar. Well, we're out of threats. Face up Den Protector. A little early for that. Or late for that, rather. This is not really good for us. He almost certainly has Wingmate Rock, so I think I have to self-inflicted wound here. I'm gonna draw two cards first. A lot of lands. I'm just going to go ahead and self-inflicted wound him. He just has to cast a Wingmate Rock. We're not in that bad of shape. But if he has another creature here, I really have to draw a removal spell. That's unfortunate. So I can attack it. I can attack Sorin. I mean, I definitely have to attack Sorin here. Unfortunately, I'm sure Sorin's just going to die and he's going to play Wingmate Rock, and then we're going to be pretty far behind. But, I mean, I have an Abzan Charm to kill one of them, so it's not the worst ever, I guess. Okay, so I guess he doesn't have Wingmate Rock. Well, that's good for us. His face of Den Protector play that turn is kind of weird then. Actually, I'm fine with that. That was a pretty good draw. I think I'm just going to play Anafenza and Abzan Charm that. Oh, and then I can also just play Warden because I have 7, so perfect. I'm going to do it now so he can't get me with a Dromoka's Command. Anafenza. Abzan Charm guy. Take 2 pain, so I'm using literal 7 colored mana this turn. Possibly still has Wingmate Rock and just thought he would be okay with his Seedrina or whatever. Now he's even pretty far behind that. Even if he like makes a flyer this turn and then rocks next turn, he's still going to be too far behind because my Warden's going to be an 8-8 by then. He has Dromoka's Command. He can fight my Warden right now. He's going to let me untap. Okay. I think I want to attack his Sorin with Shambling Vent and Anafenza. Then he can't kill my Warden. But that does mean I can't level my Warden to an 8-8 quite yet. I guess that doesn't even kill his Sorin, because my Shaman Man's only 3 power. Okay, I'm just gonna attack his Sorin with my Anafenza and my Warden. Then we're going to trade Wardens. I really don't want to trade Wardens here. Maybe I just don't care that much about his Sorin. Maybe I should just attack with an Offensa and just level this twice, and then if he doesn't have a removal spell... If he has a removal spell, that's really bad, though, because then his Sorin kind of gets out of hand. So I could still attack it with Shambling Vent. I think I want to attack it with... with Shambling Vent and an Offensa, like my original plan. 1, 2, 3... No. I'm one mana short of just... I could just animate my Shambling Vent and not attack with it. You know, tap it for mana to animate it to put a counter on it. And then if I could still level this twice, I might do that, but I'm still one short of that. So I think I'm just going to go ahead and level this once. Not right now. But so yeah, I'm going to attack with an Offensa and... Oh, not concede. Undo. An Offensa and my Shambling Vent this turn. Both be going against Sorin. Still not in good shape against a Dromoka's command. He can kill both of my attackers, basically. Although he's probably going to kill my warden. Oh, he can't actually kill, because he didn't do it on his turn, he can't kill my warden and one of my attackers, because I can respond by leveling my warden, and then they'll trade. So I guess we're fine against Dromoka's command. Okay, yeah, that was not the worst. Ultimate price, okay, that's pretty good. He's got one card left. And the Shambling Vent, now that it has a +1/+1 counter on it, is a pretty big threat because he can't just block with his Shambling Vent. So if he has like a Rhino here or Gideon, that's pretty awful for us. I'm going to have to draw something to beat that. That was a very, very unfortunate thing for him to play. That's not going to do it. Jeez. Yeah, now I don't think we can win. He's going to put us to 3. I can't attack unless I draw. If I draw a removal spell, can I survive? I'll go to 6, and he can hit me for 7, so I'm even dead. Yeah. Well, I don't know if there's much else I could have done that game. I felt like we played pretty well for the most part. Obviously, I got pretty flooded at the end, but maybe the turn... No, because he's had ultimate price, so he could have killed my... Yeah, he kills my warden no matter what I do there. I don't know, it's possible I just sideboarded kind of incorrectly. Maybe we can board out a land in this matchup. No, that doesn't seem good. There's just so many cards I want, and so few cards to take out, though. Maybe the sideboard just needs to be changed. Like, not the way I sideboard, but the actual cards in the sideboard. Anyway, so that's Abzan Aggro. I think the deck's pretty good. I plan to stick with it for a little bit, so definitely need to work on my mirror plan a little bit. So we'll see going forward. Thanks for watching.